Hey, what's going on, guys? So in this video, we're going to be reviewing or taking a look at the new trailer for the Resident Evil Infinite Darkness. Now, a fellow YouTuber, David Edwards, told me to check it out because there's some funny situations in this trailer. I told him I was shooting a movie in this medieval kind of environment last night, so I had to wait till today. So let's go ahead and check this thing out. So yeah, let's go. So right away, and this is what I don't like about Unreal Engine, is, oh my god. Want to talk about it? Did you guys see that? That lip movement? What? Every night I have the same nightmare. I mean, I'm a meta-human, and I'm using a free Livelink face app right now. Yeah, that lip sync. Oh my gosh, what the crap? I mean, the graphics looks okay. And what's crazy about this is this kind of graphics used to blow my mind out of the water, but after using Unreal Engine, it changed everything, you know? You're just so spoiled now having Unreal Engine. Okay, looks like Claire. Claire's face changes like every game. Seems like, at least. We could expose a conspiracy. I can't get anyone to go on record about the outbreak. Sorry, I don't know what to tell you. That looks good. That looks good. Capable of protecting the interests of the, but yeah, that the lip sync on this one is, we must be the source, I mean, to those who seek freedom. Is that supposed to be Ada? We cannot allow anyone to interfere with peace and prosperity. Alright, so there's some shots in there that look really good. That's classified. Yeah, it's definitely Ada Wong. You know where the root of terror comes from. It starts with fear. Oh no. Her monster look good. So that's pretty much the trailer. So this is what I'm talking about. Like, there's some major studios out there that are coming out with these animations. And meanwhile, you have Faceware Studio. You know, you can get that and do this at home, and it can look way better than that interrogation lip syncing. You know, it's just really cool. And then you have Netflix, who's willing to accept CG animations. So in a nutshell, you have Unreal Engine, which is free, you have Faceware Studio, which you can get a trial for free, and you have a Netflix company that accepts CG animations. Granted, it's probably going to be really hard to get something approved in there, but it's just so cool that you can pretty much do everything at home. Well, you need actors still to face motion cap your facial action and voice, but you know, that's where I go to websites online and look for voice actors, but that's besides the point. It's just pretty cool. As far as Resident Evil Infinite Darkness, I'm still probably going to watch it. But yeah, it's crazy how far Unreal has come with graphics and such. It just spoiled the crap out of me after using Unreal and comparing it to everything else right now. It's bananas. So you want to make a movie in Unreal Engine 4 using the new MetaHuman characters, but don't know how to do it? Well, I got the video just for you.